हम सवाल उठाए कि लड़कियां जीन्स क्यों नहीं पहन सकती हैं, क्यों लड़कियां मोबाइल लेके नहीं बात कर सकती हैं, लड़कियां क्यों देर तक रात में बाहर नहीं रह सकती हैं। अगर आज आप बदलाव लाना चाहते हैं तो मुझे लगता है कि हर रूढ़िवादी सोच, हर वो सोच जो औरतों को पीछे रखता है, उसमें हम सवाल उठाएं।
She taught me how to give. She taught me how to accept.
Person full of warmth, wisdom, and fun, which is a very unique combination.
She accepted everybody for who they were, not only people, her colleagues, but even during the training, you could see this. People would just love her.
Well, she was always very generous, and she would cook and feed people.
She always saw the glass half full.
But that was a very stable part of her personality. Nothing could change that.
She used to work with me in the early 80s in Ankur, and she was posted in a school. And in that school, Queen Elizabeth was going to visit.
So the principal told us to go to the Basti and to get all the kids that we worked with to see the Queen. So off Martha and I went to the Basti.
And as all schools are public schools, they decided for the Queen's visit, they wanted these kids in the school. They built juggies in the school, if you please, and they told these children, come tomorrow dressed in rags. So Queen Elizabeth can feel what a benevolent school and how we're raising the poor and all these quite rubbishy ideas that were there.
Martha and I were not very agreeable to that concept. So we insisted that they had bathed, they had oiled their hair, and they were nattily dressed. The principal wasn't very happy with that.
And of course, Martha was thrown out of that school and came back to the main office. So I think this incident for me showed her tremendous sense of principles and also a very strong identity as a very young person, early 20s, in her first job. But I think that really said something to me about the, you know, the kind of person that Martha was.
She was one of those 60 majority of students that quiet, committed, and engaged. She was learning from the field and giving back to the field.
So, like many students looking to do something which was different, she had been assigned to us as an intern from the Delhi School of Social Work. And that was really my first encounter, and which gradually grew into a sustained and a very long and a very close personal relationship.
She worked with me there for about 8 or 9 years in Ankur. And rose up to the level that when I left, they said, who do you think should be next? Then I selected Martha as being the next person who should be in charge. And then Martha chose to come and work with us in the new place that we set up called Creative Learning for Change.
When Martha joined Priya, she looked at the training of elected women representatives of panchayats. One of the big interests she had was what she began to call political empowerment of elected representatives. So she felt that in addition to building their capacity to be a good panchayat leader, their capacity to be a political leader also needed to be strengthened. She organized a fascinating program of panchayats to parliament and brought 100 women panchayat leaders to come and meet women leaders of parliament. Her lectures in universities and colleges were more experiential. It was this side of her which then led to, in 2005, developing a distance education wing of Priya. She looked at the curriculum and learning of political empowerment by women leaders. And in that, she partnered with colleagues from University of Victoria in Canada as well. By 2008, she developed the idea of launching the first accredited program with Indira Gandhi National Open University on participatory development. And as she began to interact with academic professors in universities around the country, I think that is where she got inspiration to do her PhD. And she chose a topic which was close to her heart, sexual harassment in the workplace.
Staring, lewd remarks, jeering, catcalls, wolf whistles, these are all part and parcel of any woman's life, be it in public transport, be it on the street, be it in a movie hall. Working women are no exception to this rule.
For me, a safe workplace would be a place where I'm judged on my work, on my capabilities to do that work, not on my gender.
Sexual harassment at workplace is something that Martha was concerned about initially from a point of view of making workplaces conducive to women.
Making workplaces safe is not about creating barriers, but it's more about sensitizing both men and women about how to conduct themselves, about how a workplace should be.
So that stream of work is very much a part of Martha Farrell Foundation.
Kadam Badhate Chalo was started, you know, after a Nirbhaya incident,
where there was a lot of youth outpouring and youth support that was seen on the streets of India.
This was Martha's way of working with young people to understand gender-based violence.
And that's we started this off in Sonipat, and now we have it now in 14, 15 locations across the country.
Martha was a very strong-willed person. She had a very deep sense of what is right and what is wrong. She always had a very clear sense of what is right for upbringing of children, what is right for relating with members of the family. And the same thing she brought to Priya. She was very clear as to how a workplace like Priya should be.
हम लोग थ्योरी पहले करते हैं, प्रैक्टिस बाद में करते हैं. वो प्रैक्टिस पहले, थ्योरी बाद में.
We've always been taught to question everything around us.
I think it's been, you know, challenging the status quo.
Don't take things at face value.
Her values were more around respect for every person, valuing their knowledge or contribution. So when she came in to Priya, she was able to create an environment where support staff, typists or accountants or people who serve in the kitchen, they also felt valued and that their work mattered.
So that is why we have a very interesting initiative in Priya, which is not there in many organizations. It's called the participatory lunch.
It's a very simple way of leveling hierarchies and differences and making people feel humane towards each other. You know, for somebody like me to sit with a young person who's just joined Priya, discuss chole bhature, is a very different level of relationship than, you know, signing checks or giving a lecture.
She allowed us to take many risks. She allowed us to make mistakes. She allowed us to, she was always challenging us. But I knew that whatever risk I took, if I made a mistake, she was there.
उनमें मतलब ये खासियत थी कि वो आपको मतलब आपके फेस से ना बचा देती थी कि जो हमारे साथ काम कर रहा है उसको क्या प्रॉब्लम है और वो कुछ हमें पता नहीं चलेगा लेकिन हमसे ज़्यादा वो हमें को पहचान लेते थे कि इसको क्या प्रॉब्लम है, घर का प्रॉब्लम है या इसको प्रेशर क्या है, तो उसका वो सॉल्यूशन दे देती थी.
उन्होंने सोचा कि नहीं, धन सिंह इससे बेटर कर सकता है, इससे इसे निकाला जा सकता है, तो उन्होंने निकाला, उस जो क्वालिटी मेरे से निकल सकते निकाला उन्होंने.
शी ऑलवेज वॉन्टेड अस टू बी द बेस्ट वी कुड.
No matter what, I could always rely on her for anything. She would give me advice, I would listen to her, but she always left the final decision to me. And no matter what that decision was, I knew that if I went back to her and it differed from what she had actually asked me to do, she would still support me. She would still always be there.
You were part of that whole environment, that whole space that was Rajesh's, Martha's. But you were welcome within that space.
सब लोग मार्था के घर तो आ जाते थे किसी भी फंक्शन में. हाँ, वो बुला लेती थी और वो आ जाते थे. सारे लोग खूब अच्छी तरीके से मज़े से घर में जो आ गया वो उनके घर का हो गया.
She loved to cook. She loved to eat and she loved to cook.
I was marveling at her ability to host and have fun at the same time, not stress her.
And also she would organize gifts. She was very thoughtful. She would select gifts for people well in advance, pack them, wrap them.
The way, Martha looked at gender, it was about equality, it was about respect, it was about, appreciating each other's strengths and doing the best in that.
She was a person who lived her life according to the values that she believed in. You can't profess one set of values and live a different set of values. I think that's perhaps one of the things that Martha represented to me.
My mother's biggest gift to me was feminism, her feminism.
Mom lives on with me in the drive that I have for life, for my work, for my family, for my friends.
I am learning more about Martha now when she's gone.
Concept nahi hai wo, wo ek asli cheez hai. Notion nahi hai wo ek. Uske jaise main keh sakti hu ki maine aur koi nahi dekha.